Marine VHF radio tips, brought to you by the Australian Communications and Media Authority.
If you've got a new VHF marine radio, then chances are it's equipped with digital selective calling.
You may even have seen the little DSC button on the set. The question is, what does it do?
DSC, or digital selective calling, means that all your boat's information is stored within your VHF radio, and with the touch of a button, all that information is broadcast to everyone within range. Now, if you're also connected to a GPS, your boat's position information is also broadcast at the same time.
That makes DSC brilliant in a distress situation. With a single touch of a button, all the important information about your boat is broadcast with accuracy to everyone within range, and that's not the only benefit of the digital system.
There's another good feature of DSC is that if you've got a mate who's also on the water and they have a DSC-enabled radio, you can call them direct on the DSC channel.
Alright, so we've decided to call in an expert in maritime communications, and it's this man, Glenn Dunstan, mate. Welcome.
Thank you, Andrew.
Why is DSC such a good thing?
A press of one button sends your position, your identity, and the nature of your distress to everybody in range. Big ships, small ships, coast stations, everyone.
Alright, well, let's find out more.
DSC works on a massive network, both in Australia and around the world. It's part of the Global Maritime Distress and Safety System, or the GMDSS, which is the world's standard marine radio distress system and is carried by all merchant ships, but also monitored by volunteer and Coast Guard radio base stations.
DSC is really a paging system. It's not that hard to use. It's a paging system that you use to tell people you've got a problem. When you send a distress alert on DSC, you're alerting everybody, everybody that can potentially help you. A coast station, if there's a merchant ship just over the horizon, he'll hear the call as well and respond. So it's a great alerting system for everyone.
On a VHF radio, DSC operates on its own dedicated channel, Channel 70. It's important to remember Channel 70 is only used to monitor DSC, not voice. Most new VHF marine radios sold have this little red distress button, meaning they have the DSC feature.
When you press the red button on your radio, the radio sends your position and identity as a digital message on channel 70. Now that message is repeated continuously every 3 to 4 minutes until the radio receives an acknowledgement message from a coast station or another ship. After you send the DSC distress alert, if you've got time, you go to channel 16 and send a normal voice mayday message.
Once you purchase a VHF radio which has DSC, there's two basic steps to setting it up.
To use DSC, you need two things. You need an identity number for the radio, which is called a maritime mobile service identity. And you also need to connect your GPS to your boat's DSC radio. Every DSC radio has a specific identity number called an MMSI, Maritime Mobile Service Identity. They're issued by AMSA, the Australian Maritime Safety Authority. And it's free. The process for issuing the MMSI is free. And so you apply online or via a 1-800 number. Now, before you can be issued with an MMSI, you have to have a Marine Radio Operator Certificate. They can be obtained from the Maritime College in Tasmania or any volunteer marine rescue station.
Once you have your MMSI, you simply hook your radio up to your boat's GPS.
GPS is really fundamental to DSC because when you send a DSC distress alert, the GPS position is automatically included in the call. Now, you can send a DSC distress alert without having the GPS connected, but there's no point really. You want people to know where you are, and the best way to do it is to connect the GPS. Different radios have different ways of doing it, but it's relatively simple. It's only a couple of connections on the back of the radio between the radio and the GPS. DSC works the same way as voice in terms of range, about 10 nautical miles between typical small boats and about 15 to 20 nautical miles from a boat to a coast station. Like voice, range is determined by the antenna height.
Okay, so we've got our MIMSI, we've got our radio connected to our GPS, and we're ready to go. It's time now to demonstrate the benefits of DSC. So to do that, we've come up to a local coast radio station here, Glenn. Now, we need to imagine that I'm in my boat. This is me here in my boat. I'm off the west coast. It's wild, it's rough, and I'm on fire. There's not even time to make a mayday call. So what do? I simply hit my distress button, like so. The alarm goes off, and back here at the Coast Radio Station, Glenn, what do you see?
At the Coast Radio Station, we'll have a message up on the screen that shows the identity number of your boat, the position, and the nature of distress. So we know who it is, and we know where they are, and what the problem is.
So just with the press of a button, help is on its way.
It sure is.
It's sort of taken the search out of search and rescue.
It certainly does.
If you are on the water and you hear a DSC alert, you should treat it exactly like a mayday call, meaning you listen in for a response by the local coast station. Of course, if no one responds within a reasonable time frame, you may need to step in.
One thing you need to bear in mind, when you send a DSC distress alert, it's a distress priority message. It indicates that your boat is threatened by grave and imminent danger and requires immediate assistance, so it's not to be treated lightly.
So the benefits of DSC are as follows.
One press of the button sends your position, your identity to everybody in range. DSC will keep transmitting unless it receives an acknowledgement message, normally from a coast station, every 3.5 to 4.5 minutes it will repeat the call. DSC doesn't only work for distress, you can do individual routine calls, you can call your friend on another boat and the alarm will ring just like a mobile phone.
For more information on marine radio issues, just go to the ACMA website. The details are on screen.